this is, you know, this is Al-Qaeda level destruction, and I'm sure Jim will agree with me.
Guys, first off, what about the fact, if this Las Vegas Journal report is true, that he was shooting at these tanks? On the side, and they did not penetrate far enough to explode them. Can you imagine if they did, Aaron?
Yeah, it would have been absolutely devastating. You know what? The entire mosaic of this attack, the amount of planning that was involved, that means that the amount of sheer blastery, or the size of that blast, had those actually gone off, 7.62 by 39 rounds, if there was an AK up there, I wouldn't be surprised if there was, or anything heavier, had that tank have gone, this is, you know, this is Al-Qaeda level destruction, and I'm sure Jim will agree with me. The amount of planning here is what's absolutely baffling me. And when you guys were talking about the chief at Las Vegas Metro believing that there was someone else involved, I have to believe that there's got to be someone else involved due to the just the basic profile of right. The lunacy of this thing. I've got to believe there's something more.
And what Aaron's saying, Jim, that's what the sheriff said. I don't have the proof. I don't have the guy. But I don't have the or the woman.
your kind permission, I'm going to show you an actual sequence of events from a 17th century bestseller called Hocus Pocus Jr. The idea here that I will cover the center ball with a cup and place one on top. Then I'll actually cover this and try to make the ball penetrate solid through solid, joining its mate below. Now that you know the sequence, why don't you follow it again? This time a ball penetrating through two solid copper cups. This method, a personal favorite of Matthew Buchinger, the little man of Nuremberg. He was only 28 inches tall. The cups obscured almost his entire body. Look, that's enough for three balls to appear below. Matthew Buchinger had no arms or legs, but he did have 14 children.